I want to announce that in honor of Minnie Pearl and tonight's deserving recipient, True Value is donating $25,000 to be split between the Minnie Pearl Cancer Fund and the charity of tonight's recipient's choice. And the check will be presented to her later in the show. And yes, I said her, because to mine, there is no one more deserving of the Minnie Pearl Award than this year's honoree. Ladies and gentlemen, Reba McEntire. You're surprised, because we really tried to keep it from you. Now, Norval, if you'll keep her in her seat, because right now we'd like to show to everyone just a few of the reasons we're honoring Reba tonight.
You know it makes me wonder.
The whole world knows Reba McEntire as one of the most successful entertainers in country music history. With What If, the fiery redhead with a heart as big as her voice decided it was time to use her celebrity status to focus on the global charitable work of the Salvation Army. Well, last year alone, they came to the aid of over 26 million Americans. Buddy, when Reba sang, the whole world listened.
Home, there stands an old house with a picket fence beneath.
Well, Reba didn't start out as a humanitarian or a singing star. She started out as one of four children of Clark McEntire, a three-time rodeo champion, and Jacqueline, from whom Reba inherited two significant characteristics, red hair and musical talent. On the McEntire, Oklahoma cattle ranch, Reba worked long and hard. In Reba's 1997 album, The Last to Know, she included songs that dealt with subjects new to country music. They reflected her desire to use her music to help and to heal.
Just across the Rio Grande.
Reba's song, Just Across the Rio Grande, addresses a very real and heartbreaking problem of the illegal immigrant. It helped Americans see our neighbors as fellow human beings with dreams. Thank you, Reba.
When Reba McEntire released her song, The Stairs, she helped remove the stigma attached with domestic violence. She became an advocate for women and children that are suffering from domestic abuse. Thank you, Reba.
All she could say, she thinks his name was John.
When Reba McEntire took a stand for AIDS awareness with She Thinks His Name Was John, it made a difference. It brought home the message that this is a disease that can affect anyone, and that's a message worth repeating. Thank you, Reba.
In 1991, tragedy struck when the plane carrying eight of Reba's band members crashed.
If I had only known, I'd never hear your voice again. I'd memorize each thing you said.
Grief-stricken Reba recorded the song, If I Had Only Known, which dealt with this terrible tragedy. It never appeared in Reba's act, but she sang it at an AIDS benefit TV special and on a music video benefiting St. Jude's Hospital, The personal care and support that Reba and the bereaved families received from the country music community reinforced Reba's feeling about the importance of reaching out to someone who is hurting.
Reba, when you sponsored the first all-female-built Habitat for Humanity house, you changed my life. That house is my home. Thank you, Reba.
The Reba McEntire Center for Rehabilitation, part of the Texoma Medical Facility, makes a difference in people's lives. After treatment, these people go on to lead happier and healthier lives. We thank you, Reba.
For the past 3 years, she has hosted the Reba McEntire Pro Celebrity Benefit, which this year raised $215,000 for children's medical research. Her visits to young patients at the Oklahoma Children's Hospital brought a very personal touch to this important project. Not only has Reba always given of her time and talent to help make a difference, with What If, she has tried to challenge and inspire us to join her by asking the question, what if, in our own lives. Gentlemen, our Minnie Pearl Award nominee, Miss Reba McEntire.
I've received of all the people who have said, Reba, you've done good, this is the one that means the most to me. Number one, because it's got my Minnie Pearl's name on it. I love Minnie Pearl very, very much. And the reason this means so much to me is because receiving an award is wonderful. It's the giving back that heals your heart, that makes it all so much better. I can't accept this by myself. Narvel, without your ideas, I've always said I'm the doer, Narvel's the thinker-upper. And it was his idea for the many, many things we've gotten to do together. So half this trophy is yours. And we're going to split it with the folks at the rehab center and Texoma Medical Center, the ranch house. We're going to share it with Gail, with the first Habitat for Humanity house. All the other things that we've gotten to do because of you, the fans, the listeners, the people who have supported us. Thank y'all so much for this. I could stand up here for days and say thank you because this is so special to me. I'll let you enjoy the show, but thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Still to come.